Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. So hari ni kita masuk chapter 3, Systems of Equations. So there are two subtopic in this chapter. The first one is System of Linear Equations in 3 Variables. And the second one is Simultaneous Equations involving one linear equation and one non-linear equation. So today, we focus on System of Linear Equations in 3 Variables. Okay, so we have two subtopic. Hari ni kita akan tengok linear system of linear equations in 3 variables. Okay, before we start, have a look at the cost of the prize of mathematics quiz competition here. Okay, the first prize, the cost is RM35. The second prize, the cost is RM25. And the third prize is Ringgit Malaysia, RM15. Okay, you boleh tengok, first prize dia dapat 3 pencil case, 3 notebooks and 4 files. Okay. Second prize dia dapat 1 kotak pensel, 3 buku nota, 1 file. And third place dia dapat 1 pencil case, 1 notebook and 2 files. Okay. So how do you determine the price of 1 pencil case, 1 notebook and 1 file here? How? Macam mana nak dapat harga setiap satu barang ni? So nak dapat harga setiap satu barang ni, you boleh dapatkan dengan cara you solve system of linear equations in 3 variables. Okay, so from here, 3 linear equations can be formed. Okay, using the variables, you can use any variable to represent the cost of each item here. Okay, let's say a notebook, 1 buku nota, cost dia RM X. File, 1 file, cost dia RM1. And 1 kotak pensel, the cost is RMZ. Okay, so 3 linear equations can be formed using the variable X, Y and Z to represent the price of 1 pencil case, 1 notebook and 1 file here. Right. Okay, so this linear equation formed are known as system of linear equations in 3 variables. Okay, sekarang kita nak cari harga setiap satu barang di sini. Kita nak cari harga kotak pensel, harga notebook, harga file kat sini. So information yang kita adalah cost. Okay, first price tadi cost dia RM35, second price RM25, okay, and third price RM15. So untuk first price, kita ada 3 kotak pensel, 3 notebooks and 4 files. And the cost of all the items here is RM35. So how to get RM35 here? Okay, tadi notebook harga dia setiap satu RMX. File setiap satu harga dia Y. Pencil case harga dia setiap satu RMZ. So how to get total cost untuk first price ni, RM35 ni, macam mana nak dapat? So mestilah you buat apa? You ambil bilangan darab dengan harga setiap satu barang, then you plus everything lah, nak dapat total kan, total cost. Okay, so untuk first price, okay, so you ada notebook ada 3. Okay, setiap satu notebook harganya X. So nak dapat cost, 3 times X become 3X. Okay, next, File ada berapa? Ada 4. Harga setiap satu Y. So jadi 4 times Y lah. Bilangan darab dengan harga, dapatlah cost dia. So disebabkan kita nak total kan, nak dapat total cost, kita kena plus. Okay, 4 file darab dengan setiap satu Y. Okay, then last kali kita ada pencil case. Kat sini kita ada hamil 3. And then setiap satu cost dia Z. So 3Z. Okay, all together RM35. So we get one equation. So you can see here you have 1, 2, 3 variables. And all the variable here is power of 1. So it is linear. Okay, linear equation in 3 variables. That's why we called it linear equations in 3 variables. Okay, cuba fikir pula. untuk second prize ni, macam mana nak dapat total cost RM25. Okay, notebook ada berapa ni? 1, 2, 3. So 3 notebook X ringgit kan. So 3X plus file ada 1, so plus 1 times Y, Y lah, plus pencil case ada 1, so 1 times Z, Z. Total cost is RM25. You get one more equation. Okay, and the third price, total cost is okay, notebook ada 1, setiap 1 X ringgit, so 1 times X is X, plus file ada 2, so 2 times Y lah, 2Y, plus pencil case ada 1, Z lah, equal RM15 altogether. So now you see, kita ada linear equations in 3 variables, 1, 2, 3, and all the variables here is power of 1. So once power of 1, it is linear. Okay, okay. So next, let's see how to solve all this equation. So actually tadi kita nak cari harga setiap satu bar, harga setiap satu item ni kan. So kita nak cari harga kotak pensel, satu kotak pensel berapa ringgit. So kalau kita dapat Z, maknanya kita dah dapat harga kotak pensel. Okay, kalau then kita nak cari harga notebook ni, satu berapa ringgit. So kalau kita dapat value X, means kita dah dapat harga untuk notebook. Okay, dan juga kita nak dapatkan harga file, setiap satu file berapa ringgit. So kalau kita dapat value Y, meaning kita dah dapat harga file untuk setiap satu ni lah. Okay, let's see, kita sambung next video. Okay, bye.